And today I just wanted to bring you some tips on how to get moving and stay moving. Now, you saw my before and after picture. I've lost 120 pounds. I have a son who is about a year and a half old, and I've been through some pretty serious surgeries and had to recover. And people seem surprised when I tell them that it's not always easy for me either. I didn't grow up very athletic. I didn't grow up staying active and moving. So I struggle daily with getting myself moving and staying active. It's not fun. It's not always easy. I shouldn't say it's not always fun, because it is fun once you get going and you start seeing results. I am tired all the time. My poor little guy still doesn't sleep through the night, so I am up every single night with him. So it is tough. It is always tough, especially now that I know what it's like to be a mom. If you're working, it is really, really hard. And there are a lot of ways that you can really just kind of push working out aside, but then you end up feeling worse about it. So I wanted to share with you some of the simple tips that I have done throughout my entire weight loss journey and still do to this very day that definitely helped me to stay motivated and to keep moving. And on the days that I just don't have energy or I don't feel like working out, these tips really get me. A bunch of cardio music that I did when I was teaching my kickboxing classes that I'm not doing right now, but they are 150 beats per minute. And I always have that on when I'm going downstairs with the intention to work out. I have a studio set up in my house and I have a place where my workouts happen if I can. You can either move to that beat, there's no slowing down. So having good motivational music is really important for me when I'm working out. Now my second tip is making sure you're wearing the proper bra, good clothes that breathe, the pants that fit you properly that aren't gonna fall off when you're jumping around. Same thing goes with your hair. Make sure your hair is pulled back properly, you got headbands, the right kind of ponytail holder or scrunchie so that your hair's not falling out and flopping around in the middle of your workout. I hate when that happens. It distracts me. So find the right clothes that make you feel comfortable when you're getting your workout in. And a little added thing here, if you can, find clothes that make you feel cute too. Go out and buy some cute workout clothes, because then you'll enjoy putting them on. So the next thing you want to do is make your workouts non-negotiable, just like anything else in your day. Speaking to moms, but this goes to men too. I am a mom and a wife and I have a job, and I found ways to make it work. So my workouts are non-negotiable. You find ways to get those workouts in. And one way that helps me is, even though I know I'm gonna remember this, I put it in my phone. I put it in my planner so that my alarm clock is going. So my reminder goes off and it tells me, you know, either what routine I want to do that day or this is your workout time, because it almost makes me feel guilty, like it's in my face. So if I didn't have that alarm going off and reminding me, I probably very well could have been like, oh, okay, I'm not going to work today. But the second it goes off, all of those feelings of trying to be determined and motivated when I put that reminder in there all come back, and I'm like, ugh, it's in my planner, I got to do it. So I find a way to do it. And So my next tip is to stop overthinking it. So I'm not trying to put anyone down or make you feel bad if you are a mom or a dad or somebody with very limited time. I know that it's hard, but stop overthinking your workouts. Now, I know that you can feel stressed out trying to get your clothes together, go to a gym, figure out what routine should I be doing today, you know, what body part should I be working today, should I be doing cardio, should I be doing this and that and that. And it's overwhelming and sometimes to the point where you don't even want to start. So stop overthinking your workouts. Here's something that I do. I tried working out during my son's naps after I had him. My world changed in a fabulous way once I had him, and I had to try to figure out how to make working out a part of my life still while I'm living in this whole new different life, which has become absolutely amazing. So for a while, so then I would find myself not getting my workouts in, or say he would have a short nap and so I just didn't get it in, or I needed to shower, you know, all of those things, or I needed to nap. So what I started doing was I created an environment that was kid friendly and safe for him, and I got very creative with my workouts. We have so much fun, and yeah, there's some days he's a little bit more clingy, but we make it work. He knows that mommy works out. He cracks up when I'm doing jumping jacks, mountain climbs, push-ups, he climbs on my back. I've made him a part of my workout routine. He thinks it's hilarious when I grab like his little pushing toys and I run across the floor, and he thinks I'm playing with him, which I am. But that's a workout when you're pushing a toy and running, or put him in a basket and I push him across the carpet. So just an example of how you can make your workouts work and you don't have to overthink it. As long as you are moving, you're getting your heart rate up. There are a lot of times I use zero equipment. I use my son for weight sometimes if I'm doing squats, or I can use my staircase, or I'm simply doing kind of the routines that I'm showing you. The stuff that really, really works, and all it is your body, you know, burpees, push-ups, jumping jacks, jump lunges, squats, all of those things. So get creative with your workouts and don't overthink it. Don't worry, just move, just do something. My next tip is mix things up. Now, if I were to tell you, hey, you had this scheduled, you had to this day you gotta lift weights, so you know what, the day comes and I might not feel like doing that, and that's okay. So I really mix things up. I have got just a ton of exercises in my mind so that if I just don't feel like doing something, I can box, because I always want to box, or I can do my cardio kickboxing moves, just put on some good music and just jump around for a half hour. So for me, that's my job. So I have all these exercises in my mind, in my head. I'm a personal trainer, I know what works, and I get that not everybody can do that sort of thing and just wing a workout. So here's my channel. All of those sorts of things are on here. What I'm giving you are just at home, real workouts that I do that have worked for me, that have helped me lose 120 pounds, and I'm 60 pounds lighter now from when I had my son. So these things work. So if that's your problem, if you feel like you just don't know how to mix up your workouts, then you need to stick with my channel. You need to subscribe, you need to make sure you're looking into my playlist and watch my videos, listen to what I'm saying, and I'm giving you incredible tips. You don't have to go to classes, you don't have to go to a gym, and you don't have to have any equipment. So just mix things up, have fun with your workouts. You can even dance, you know, put on some good, it doesn't matter if you're a good dancer or not. Or you can like learn dance moves and actually learn how to do them the right way, and you might look silly, but so what? Just do it at home, no one cares, have fun. Find something that keeps you going and give yourself variety, and just don't, back to that tip I just said, just don't overthink it. Just move, work out, get a little sweat going on, get that heart rate up. Give yourself a half hour. You'll be amazed. Yeah. You started, and whatever it is, that put that initial thought that I need to do something. So write post-it notes, stick them on your refrigerator. There's a certain inspirational quote that makes you just kind of on fire, or maybe there's a wedding you're going to, or at an event that you want to look your best for, you want to feel great for. Write those little things out. Stick them all around you. Put them in your phone. Every time, like every morning, my phone goes off and there's a quote that I like. And then a few hours later, there's my workout that I want to do that day. And you can't escape it when you don't let yourself. So inspire yourself. You are the only one who can keep you moving. Yes, I can say you are the only one who can keep you moving. Yes, I can say things, I can post quotes, I can get up here on YouTube and give you all sorts of workouts and inspirational tips, and you can follow me on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, and I'm giving you all of these things that should inspire you and keep you moving. But bottom line is, nobody can do that for you. You have to do that for you. So that tip, remind yourself that, you know what, I said I was gonna start today. You know, I said I was gonna work out today. I'm doing this for me. You know what, I said I was gonna start today. You know, I said I was gonna work out today. I'm doing this for me. Have that time for you, and hold yourself responsible for it. So use technology in the palm of your hand. Use your phone. Just get those constant reminders and quotes and pictures and things to show up. Pin them to your fridge. Put them wherever you're getting dressed. Put them on your mirror. These things seriously work. You probably heard me say it before, and you probably heard others say it before. But surround yourself with positive energy, positive thoughts. So much happens inside your head before it comes out. So start. Thanks so much for watching. I hope this helps someone out there. Let me know if you have any questions. Please subscribe, leave me some comments and feedback, and share my channel with everyone so that I can help people all over the world. So